Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at the Paint Selection tool in Pixelmator. So the Paint Selection tool was something added in the last update of Pixelmator. And it's another in a long series of different ways where you can select part of an image. So in the past you might have used the magic wand tool, say in Photoshop, or maybe something like Smart Lasso in Preview. Well, with this tool here, the Paint Selection tool, you basically paint to select. So I'm going to try to select me out of this photo. And I have a brush here and I can change the brush size here. And I can just paint, and you can see it will select me as I paint over parts of me, and it will add more as it learns more about what I'm selecting. So I'll just fill in here, grab my ear, grab some hair, and just keep going. It's always going to select the area that you paint and then any similar nearby areas that it thinks also belong. And what I can do here is I can stop, and you can see it has that selection. Now I can use the shift key, and you see my cursor changes to a plus and the option key changes it to a minus. Plus and minus. So I'm going to plus and then keep drawing, holding the shift key down, and you can see now it's selected even more. So holding the shift key down and selecting more, I'm going to keep painting until I select everything. And then also notice that sometimes it's going to select things you don't want, and that's where you get to use the minus. So here it selected a portion of the background. I'm going to do option and select minus and just paint that out. And you can see now that's not selected anymore. And I'm going to add the glass to the selection. Get my thumb in there. And you see it's going to reselect areas. That's fine since I'm adding. And let's see what I've got here. Oh, it selected this again. So let me option and deselect it. There. So now I've got a pretty good outline of me. Here's another area that I want to deselect. There we go. So I've got a pretty good outline. I can test this by using Command and X to cut. And you can see that it pretty much cut me out there. I can add a little bit more here. And again, I have to remove this part. It's very similar to the color of my shirt. So Command X. And there we go. We got a pretty good cutout very quickly by painting rather than selecting. So now what can you do with this? Well, the next thing you want to do is you want to refine the selection a little bit more. And you can do that under Edit, Refine Selection right here. Now with this I can then more clearly see the selection. As you can see, it's kind of masks out the rest there. And I can increase the size of the selection or decrease it. But it's where I want it to be right now, so I'm going to leave it at zero. But I could feather it, and what feathering does is it adds a little bit extra around the edges, but it's semi-transparent. So it's kind of going to create this feathered look around the edges. And this really works well. It doesn't work so well if you copy and paste into another image, because you're going to get a little bit of the background, kind of a fuzzy version of the background around the end. But if you're going to, you know, just change the look of either what's inside the selection or outside of the selection, then feathering is a good idea. So I'm going to feather just at about 5% and say OK. Now I can, for instance, see I can cut it there again, or I can Command C for copy and create a new document, paste it in, and I can see what it is I've selected. I can see the feathering probably could be a little bit better there. So I'm going to go back in here. I'm going to undo the refine selection. And I'm going to do it again here. And I'm going to just do a little more feathering. 26% there. Now when I copy and create a new document and paste it in, I could see I get a much nicer version here where you can see just a little bit of the background showing through, which is fine because I want to use that as I change the image. So now if I were to copy this out of here, I could see I actually have another document open there, and I can paste into it. And you can see it pastes in pretty well. You can see there's a little bit of feathering around the edges there, but that's okay. That kind of works as long as the backgrounds are about the same. It kind of almost makes it look like a shadow because the background is darker in the other image. But let's go back here, and what I want to do is, what I really want to do is add an effect. So I'm going to go to View and Show Effects here. It's going to bring up the Effects Browser, and now I'm going to look at all effects, and just let's add something simple here, like something that would change the exposure. And I can drag and drop that on to the selected area, and I can change the exposure, and you can see it's not changing the background exposure at all. Now in a lot of cases it's not as useful to actually change the selected area but change the rest of it. So I can go to Edit and I can go to Invert Selection, and now what's actually happened is it selected everything except what I had selected before, inverted it. So when I drag and drop the exposure onto the background, I can actually change the exposure of the background while leaving the selected area the same. And exposure is pretty boring, so we could do something really cool like, say, make the background black and white like that. And I can undo. And then there's tons of different really cool effects that you could apply. You can go for something really bizarre, like to pointillize the entire background. You can see it leaves a selected area unchanged. Or you could add some sort of other cool effect in the background like that, like a fog effect. You can pixelize it. There's tons of effects that you could play with. There, you can see create an old photo, and now you can see I'm in full color and the background looks like an old photo. And of course I could have done the opposite of that by applying that to the selection here instead of inverting the selection and doing it back there. So there's a little bit of fun using the paint selection tool on Pixelmator. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. Go to that page. Underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.